Since Friday, the fate of over 600,000 refugees living in Kenya has been hanging in the balance after the government shut down operations at the Department for Refugee Affairs. Treasury Cabinet Secretary Henry Rotich saying the decision was occasioned by the heavy financial burden coupled with security challenges that could see the possible closure of Dadaab and Kakuma refugee camps.
The burden for Kenya has been huge. The international community seems to be a little bit, getting also fatigued on the matter. And also on the issues of AMISOM, it's very clear that also there is a fatigue setting in. And, if that happens, then it's become a challenge also for host countries hosting all these refugees.
For 30 years, Kenya has had to shoulder the economic burden brought about by the influx of refugees into the country. But now the United Nations is calling on the government to reconsider Friday's decision to disband the Department for Refugees Affairs. In a statement, UNHCR says with some 60 million people forcibly displaced, it is more important than ever that international asylum obligations prevail and properly supported. The agency urging the government to reconsider its decision and to avoid taking any action that might be at odds with international obligations toward people needing sanctuary from danger and persecution. This even as EU heads of delegation to Kenya, Ambassador Stefan Odejak, said in-depth negotiations will take place to help address Kenya's concerns.
I'm very confident that within this renewed political dialogue that we have with the government of Kenya, we'll be able to address issues that are of mutual concern in the best way.
Dejek said the European Union has since 2007 been in the forefront in the funding of AMISOM troops in Somalia to help bring lasting peace in the Horn of Africa. The refugee crisis has become a global concern, with countries like Turkey issuing ultimatums to the European Union if it wants Turkey to take back refugees fleeing countries like Syria. Back home, the government insists it will not provide services to refugees despite a number of them showing up at the Department for Refugee Affairs in Shauri Moyo.
Serikali ya Kenya, tunaomba kwa unyenyekevu atusaidie.
Serikali atuangalie sana atusaidie, hiyo ndio maombi yangu.
Sisi naomba serikali anasaidia sisi na waachilia hii maskini sisi watu yake. Samani amekaribisha msuri.
For Channel One News Hour, I am Edward Kabasa.